Stories we love best do live in us forever. So whether you come back by the page or by the big screen, Hogwarts will always be there to welcome you home. On the day of the world premiere of the last film, these words were enunciated by the most talented witch the world of literature has ever seen, Madam J.K. Rowling.
I, Rohit Chokhani,
and I, Mehul Agarwal, welcome you all to the first ever intra-college themed quiz, PotterScore 2017. I would like to introduce you to our teams for the day. Rohit Churiwala and Reema Matia, the riddles.
Yogesh Dhariwal and Simran Kukreja, the Flamels.
Shreya Tulsiyan and Radhika Saraf, the Weasleys.
Vatsala Jhunjhunwala and Pooja Ardas, the Snapes.
Vaishali Singhania and Vedika Agarwal, the Patils.
Abhishek Ranka and Arijit Paul, the Degrees.
Aditya Gupta and Surbhi Agarwal, the Grangers.
Manav Sharma and Soham Das, the Malfoys.
Neha Mishra and Gaurav Bose, the Lovegoods.
Udayan Mitra and Barsha Roy, the Blacks.
Saurabh Sir and Shinjini Ma'am, the Peverils.
Salman Ahmed and Shivam Agarwal, the Potters.
And Mayank Agarwal and Anirban Das, the Longbottoms. Now let us begin with round one, You Know Who. Since Harry came to know about You Know Who in his very first year, we expect you to identify people, places and stuff from the Harry Potter universe in this very first round. Each team will be given two riddles, which you would need to solve. Plus 10 for correct answer, no negative marking for incorrect answers, and no pass to any other team. With this, I would also like to request you all not to prompt any of the answers.
She's a Hufflepuff student in Harry's year, a member of Dumbledore's army. Her aunt is head of the Department of Magical Law Enforcement. We see her in the first movie.
Susan Bones?
That's the correct answer. She was the daughter of a Hogwarts founder. She stole her mother's diadem and hid it. She was killed by the Bloody Baron and became Ravenclaw's house ghost.
Helena Ravenclaw.
That's the correct answer.
It is a three-headed dog belonging to Rubius Hagrid, protector of the Philosopher's Stone.
Fluffy.
Yes, right answer. She's an evil red-eyed cat belonging to a Hogwarts staff who sneaks around at night looking out of bed students.
Mrs. Norris.
Okay, yeah, right answer. A magical plant which when eaten by a wizard and a witch or a witch helps to grow gills and webbing between the fingers and toes, allowing them to process oxygen
Gillyweed.
From water.
Gillyweed.
That is the right answer. Okay. Round one. The riddles are at... You haven't opened your account. The Flamels on 10. The Weasleys on 10. The Snapes, 20. The Patils, 5. The Degrees haven't opened their account as well. The Grangers haven't opened their account as well. The Malfoys, 15. Lovegoods, 0. Blacks, 15. Peverils, 10. Potters, 20. And Longbottoms, 10.
Now it's time for round 2, Muffiliato. This spell prevents nearby people from listening to conversations. This spell will now be casted so that you hear only what we play and see only what we show in the audio-visual round. Each team would be given an answer sheet to fill in the answers to the 20 audio-visual based questions. Plus 10 for correct answer, no negative marking for incorrect answers. This round would follow elimination of two teams. Okay, sorry, three teams.
Minister?
Yes.
I don't understand.
Understand?
I broke the law.
underage wizards aren't allowed to use magic at home.
Oh, come now, Harry. The Ministry doesn't send people to Azkaban for blowing up their aunt. On the other hand, running away like that, given the state of things...
Okay, so your question is, who is the reason behind the state of things as suggested by Cornelius Fudge?
It is clear that we can expect great things from you. After all, he who must not be named did great things. Terrible. Yes. But great.
So you heard a voice, and your question is, whose voice is this? And your time starts now.
The Ministry has concluded that for their own safety, no student under the age of 17 should be allowed to put forth their name for the Triwizard Tournament. This decision
That's rubbish!
Okay, you saw a person announcing, right? Which post is this person at? You have to write his post, his designation. Time starts now.
In the dream, were you standing next to the victim? Or looking down at the scene?
Neither. It was like I... Professor, will you please just tell me what's happening?
Everard, Arthur's on guard duty tonight. Make sure he's found by the right people.
Sir.
We hear that Dumbledore asks Harry about a dream. So whom did Harry dream about? Like, name the person whom Harry saw in his dream. Okay guys, now I would request you all to submit your sheets to the volunteers. Guys, a huge round of applause for all the teams first. So the three teams that are being eliminated are the Riddles, the Partles and the Lovegoods. Guys. Thank you, but you need to join the audience.
Okay, hello everyone. So let's begin round three, which is called Spellbound. So as we all know, a very essential part of magic is the spells which the witches and wizards cast. Like, what are magic people without spells? This round tests your knowledge of spells in different ways. Which spell is used to produce a snake?
Drop and sort, yeah.
Be very correct about your pronunciation.
Yeah.
The serpent sword, yeah.
Okay, that's the correct answer. What is the use of the spell Confundus?
Confusing. Confusing the opponent.
Yeah, that is correct.
Correct answer.
Which spell is used to animate the statues and armor suits? Which spell is used to animate the statues and armor suits?
Pier Totem Locomotor.
Yeah, that is correct. In Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 1, which spell does Harry use to break the layer of ice over the pond which had the sword of Godric Gryffindor?
Defendo.
That is correct.
So the two teams that get eliminated are the Degrees and the Grangers. Eight pieces in a line in a chessboard. Eight teams that stay. Since you have the option to move whichever piece you want, here we give you four options to answer your questions. But here's the catch. One question will be based on the trivia surrounding the Harry Potter universe, that is nothing directly mentioned in the books or shown in the films, and the other would be based on a quote or a dialogue from the books or the films. Who said the following? This team. Honestly, am I the only person who has ever bothered to read Hogwarts: A History? Minerva McGonagall, Luna Lovegood, Charity Burbidge or Hermione Granger?
Hermione Granger.
Correct. Who said the following to Neville? It's high time your grandmother learned to be proud of the grandson she's got. rather than the one she thinks she ought to have. Harry Potter, Nymphadora Tonks, Luna Lovegood, or Minerva McGonagall?
Minerva McGonagall.
Okay, that's the right answer. This team. What was Voldemort's boggart? Harry, Dumbledore, his orphanage, or his own corpse?
His own corpse.
Plus 20. Correct answer. How was Ginny Weasley associated with the Daily Prophet? She became the editor, she was the senior Quidditch correspondent, she was a gossip columnist, or was she not associated at all? That passed.
Number 2. The senior Quidditch correspondent.
Correct answer. So guys, we clearly have the winners now. Longbottoms win with 265. Snapes are second with 250. The Weasleys are third with 240. Sorry. Okay, now we'll begin with the award ceremony. Firstly, the second runner-ups, Radhika and Shreya, please come on the stage. Second prize, the runner-ups, Vatsala and Pooja. And now, obviously, the winners, Mayank and Anirban.
Thank you so much, everyone. Till then, just keep loving Harry Potter. And whenever someone dares to question your craze for Harry Potter, just reply,
always.